In South Africa, grievances unleashed by the jailing of ex-president Jacob Zuma boil over into the worst violence in years. Protests that followed Zuma's arrest last week have widened into looting and outpouring of general anger over the hardship and inequality that persist 27 years after the end of the apartheid. More than 70 people have been killed in the unrest, which has spread from Zuma's home province to other areas of the country, including Johannesburg. Soldiers have been sent onto the streets to try to restore order. Zuma was sentenced last month for defying a constitutional court order to give evidence on high-level corruption during his 9 years in office. He also faces trial in a separate case on charges including corruption, fraud, racketeering, and money laundering. He pleaded not guilty in court in May.
In other news, the Delta COVID-19 variant forces Israel to rethink its pandemic rules. As this report tells us, face masks are making a comeback as the government tries to avoid another hard lockdown.
4 weeks ago, Israel was celebrating a return to normal life. Then along came the more infectious Delta variant of COVID-19. A surge in cases meant a change of course. Israelis had stopped wearing masks and abandoned social distancing after one of the world's fastest vaccination drives. Now it has reinstated the mandatory wearing of face masks indoors and quarantine for all people arriving in Israel. Prime Minister Naftali Bennett calls the policy soft suppression. His government wants Israelis to learn to live with the virus and to develop herd immunity. It plans to impose the fewest possible restrictions and avoid a fourth national lockdown that could further batter the economy. That strategy is drawing parallels with Britain as it lifts all restrictions. Doctors like Gadi Sigal, who heads a coronavirus ward, remain concerned.
We must find the right moment to limit the entry of new mutations from abroad, and the government must find a way to limit further spreading of the virus in the community, because the virus won't stop. It is evolving, it is nature, but our nature is to survive.
Daily infections are running at about 450, with the Delta variant making up some 90% of cases. About 45 people are in hospital with severe COVID. Around 60% of Israelis have received at least one shot of the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine. And on Sunday, the government began offering a third shot for those with compromised immunity.
In France, hundreds of thousands rushed to set up vaccine appointments amid new measures to combat a surge in COVID-19 infections. On Monday night, President Emmanuel Macron said a health pass would now be used much more widely, including to enter restaurants, cinemas, and theaters. And in just 24 hours after that announcement, some 1.7 million appointments were set up through one of France's biggest booking websites. Daily vaccinations also hit a new high of more than 792,000 on Tuesday. France has given nearly 53% of its population at least one dose of the vaccine, and 37% are fully vaccinated.